Hey there and welcome to my Cairns property market update. There's three things I'm going to cover off in this report. It's going to be stock levels, what's happening with those, also buyer activity here in Cairns, and what are happening with the prices. So let's start with stock levels. So currently we've got very short stock levels. Pre-COVID, just to give you an idea, 2,612 properties available at any one time versus 751 active listings, excluding land and units in the Cairns Greater region at the moment. Now, if you take out the under contract, that remains only 498. So not much to choose from. But you combine that with 302 agents in Cairns, which have sold in the last 12 months, makes it a very competitive market out there. So why do we have low stock? That's one of the questions that I'm being asked. And you see, whatever goes online is selling pretty quickly. We're seeing a turnover rate of about 2 weeks still. So the time on market is very low. So they're not sitting there for a long time. Also, what we're finding is buyers that are trading a home, so if they're moving up or moving down and they're wanting to sell to buy, they're a little bit apprehensive of putting their property on the market, getting it sold quickly, and then being stuck with nothing to buy. Also, if they're looking to rent, it's still a quite tight rental market out there, so the challenge is finding a rental. So we're finding sellers are being a little bit more fussy, and they deserve to be, waiting for the perfect one to come up. And they're getting themselves ready, get an equity check on their property, find out how much they're sitting on, and then they can use that equity to then get a bridging loan to purchase another one, and then they can move into that and put their property on the market. Buyer activity, we spoke about that, that's number two. So, well, open home numbers are down. So from this month compared to June, we had 466 open for inspection attendees as opposed to 676 in June. So there's less buyers out there. Also, first home buyers are cautious at the moment. It's actually cheaper to rent cheaper to rent than it is to buy at the moment, given the interest rate levels. So the surge of buyers entering into the market are not where we'd seen in previous years. Investors are slowly returning back into the market, which is good, but very, very slowly. Will they come back in full force? Well, we sincerely hope so, because we're desperate for new investment properties. About one third of all properties that sold in the previous 12 months to this year were investment properties. So we need them back in the market. Why are investors a little bit apprehensive? Well, you know, returns are improving, but so are risk-free returns as well. And investors are facing higher interest rates and also higher tax. And there's these new unfavorable tenancy laws which are causing a little bit of trepidation of entering into the market. But bricks and mortar for the long term have always returned really well. Okay, so let's talk about house prices. What have the house prices been doing? Well, so far in Cairns this year, year to date, Cairns house prices have increased 3.3% and units have increased 4.4%. So prices are still on the rise. A year on year though, from this time last year, house prices have gone up 4.7% and 7.2% in units. So units are accelerating in value. They've been quite low for some time and now they're gaining some ground. Interestingly enough, since the price growth started in 2020 post-COVID, houses have actually gone up on average in Cairns 40.7% and units 44%. So if you bought before 2020, it's going to make sense to get an equity check. You may be extremely surprised how much equity that you're sitting on in your current property to maybe then go and buy an investment property. So house sales though are down 16.3% year on year. So there's less properties selling at the moment. Also new listing stock is dropping a little bit. It's down 8.4% year on year. And we're 36% down on a 5-year average. So there's way less stock available at the moment. So this low supply is keeping demand up, even though buyer activity's fallen. So it's still quite an active market. Little touch on the rental market. Rental stock is historically low. As I said before, we really do need some more investors. Our vacancy rates at the moment here at Toomey Schwaber Property Group are 0.3%, massively low. It's still really tight. However, tenant numbers are falling slightly. We're getting on an average now 9 applications per rental property, as opposed to 16 applications just a few months ago. I would expect a balanced market for the remainder of this year. That's just my opinion, just seeing what's on the ground here. I'm not expecting any sharp price increases or any dramatic price drops. I think we'll stay generally steady. So, well, that's the market wrap-up for this month here. Thanks very much for those who have taken the opportunity to get an equity check with myself. It's been really interesting visiting lots of homes. People are buying investment properties or upgrading their insurances. They were massively underinsured and they didn't realize it. So if you'd like to take advantage of that, give me a call, shoot me a quick email, and I'd be happy to pop out quick 10 minutes and just do an equity check and find out what your property is worth in the current market. Well, thanks for watching, and tune in next month.